On tonight's Gwinnett Prep Rally, great matchups from all over the county. Brookwood's home opener against Collins Hill is here. Could the Eagles finally get a win over the champs? Number 1 versus number 2 in AA, would Buford continue its winning ways against Carver Columbus? Norcross looking to stay perfect on the year. They travel to the Big Orange Jungle, while South Gwinnett and ML King go at it on a Thursday night special. And a couple of newer programs battle it out with Mountain View taking on Archer. We've got all the highlights, so fire up your pom-poms and get your war paint on, because Gwinnett Prep Rally starts right now.
For more than 15 years, your source for Gwinnett County sports is Gwinnett Prep Rally.
Hello again and welcome to your county's original high school sports television program. This is Gwinnett Prep Rally, now in its 19th season, and we can be seen right here on GCPS-TV for the entire 2011-2012 school year. I'm Todd Klein alongside Will Hammack from the Gwinnett Daily Post. And Will, it was another good weekend of high school football in Gwinnett County with a couple of teams getting some signature victories.
Yeah, the two that stand out to me, obviously Buford beating Carver, and then North Gwinnett going over and winning against St. Augustine, Florida. Both those were kind of signature wins early in the season. For Buford, really impressive to beat the only team that beat them last season. So Buford's got a lot of talent. It's good to see them win a huge game like that on the field.
Well, let's get right to the highlights. And the Brookwood Broncos have owned Collins Hill on the gridiron during their first 10 meetings, including last year's regular season and state semifinal wins. So you know the Eagles were looking for a little revenge when they paid a visit to Snellville this past Friday night. GPR's Nathan Shutter was there.
Brookwood playing host to Collins Hill in their home opener. Eagles on the offensive. Bradley Johnson's pass is too high for Nick England, and DJ Brown makes the shoestring interception for Brookwood. Broncos will take advantage. Zach Moon pitches it to Jamal Cole, and he will do the rest. Sneaking into the end zone for the touchdown, Brookwood up 7-0. Broncos on the move once again. Moon with a pass to Colin Cotter, and he picks up a nice chunk of yardage before being forced out of bounds. Later in the drive, Nick Tompkins plunges into the end zone from 1 yard out to give Brookwood a 14-0 lead. Eagles looking for something on offense. Johnson's pass is deflected by Christopher Dancy right to Jamal Cole for the interception, and Cole will be rewarded a couple of plays later, spinning his way into the end zone from 6 yards out. Brookwood in control up 21-0 at the break. Second half, Broncos looking to add on, but Moon's pass sails high over his intended receiver, and it's picked off by Daniel Fish for the Eagles. Collins Hill will make a change at quarterback Brett Sheehan, looking downfield, but he's going to be sacked by Javier Dyer, and the drive would stall. Fourth quarter, Collins Hill knocking on the door. Sheehan dumps it off to Nick England, and he does the rest, scampering his way in for the touchdown. Eagles down 21-7. Brookwood looking to chew up some clock. Nick Tompkins running hard and breaking tackles for the big gain and the Brookwood first down. The Broncos would have to settle for a Brandon Morrow field goal attempt. He knocks it through from 38 yards, and Brookwood beats Collins Hill 24-7.
Well, Will, Brookwood's offense looked a little better in this one, but the defense continues to impress.
Yeah, it's two great games out of the defense, two games into the season. That was a big key in this one. The offense had a great first half in this one. The second half kind of sputtered, but the defense just kept getting it done, keeping Collins Hill from doing anything, limiting the Eagles to 107 yards. So despite all those graduation losses from last year, a great effort by Brookwood.
Well, back to the highlights, and one of the county's newest rivalries, Archer and Mountain View, both opened their doors in 2009, so it's not a big surprise that these two are usually compared to one another. And Archer had a chance to tie up the all-time series at 2 games apiece with a win on Friday night. GPR's Daryl Shore has more.
Mountain View taking on Archer. The Tigers got the best of them last year in this matchup. First quarter, Ernest Alexander getting the handoff, breaking a tackle, and going down the sideline 32 yards for the touchdown. Makes it 6-0 Archer. And how about some defense? Chris Bartlett rolling out looking for Frederick Hill. The ball gets batted around, but DeAndre Singleton comes up with the juggling interception for Archer. Second quarter now, more from the Tigers' ground game and more from Ernest Alexander. This time 37 yards for another touchdown, makes it 12-0 Archer at the half. Third quarter now, Mountain View comes back. Chris Bartlett to Eddie West. He goes in from 10 yards out to cut it to 12-7. But Archer would tack on 2 more field goals and pull away to take it 18-7 over Mountain View.
Nice win there for Archer. We'll talk about Archer now, kind of maturing as a program. What do you expect from them this season?
Yeah, I think they've come along nicely. I think what they've done is build toward the season. When they first opened, you saw Mountain View get success right away. win those first two meetings, but I think and that was because they played so many upperclassmen. And Archer, they're playing a lot of freshmen and sophomores their first year of football. So now those kids are growing up, they're juniors and seniors, and they're really leaders of this bunch, and they have high hopes for this season. They think they can make the playoffs.
Well, more highlights now, and Carver-Columbus is one of the few teams that can claim bragging rights over Buford during the last couple of years. The Tigers handed the Wolves their only loss of the season in 2010, but payback was waiting when they made the trip to Buford this past Friday night. Nathan Shutter has the call.
It was a battle of the top two teams in AA, Carver-Columbus and Buford. First quarter, Buford strikes first. Andre Johnson going right up the gut for the four-yard score makes it 7-0 Wolves. Second quarter now, Buford driving again. The handoff goes to Nathan Staub. He cuts it to the sideline, breaks a tackle, and he is gone. 45 yards for the touchdown, makes it 14-0 Buford at the half. Third quarter, more of the same. Andre Johnson finding a hole, and he weaves his way through the defense and finally gets brought down at the 12-yard line. And they would punch it in again. Staub, banging his way in for the 1-yard touchdown, makes it 21-0 Buford. Carver-Columbus with some issues on special teams. The bad snap goes into the end zone. The punter grabs it and is forced out of bounds at the 13-yard line. So Buford takes over and they capitalize again. Andre Johnson one more time puts the Wolves on top 28-0. Fourth quarter, Buford back on offense, and Johnson finishes it again with the 5-yard scamper for the touchdown, and Buford wins big, 35-7 over Carver-Columbus.
Well, just another dominating performance there, Will, by the Buford team. Do you expect that to continue this season? And if and when will they get a test?
Yeah, I don't know if there is a test out there for Buford and AA. Just a very impressive football team all the way around. They're excellent in all aspects of the game. And just watching those highlights, just seeing some of the blocking that went on, not just at the line of scrimmage, but downfield, just knocking guys all over the place. They're going to be able to run the ball on whoever they want this season. And that defense is just maybe the best defense they've ever had at Buford, which is a scary thought.
All right, Will, when we come back, we'll have more football highlights as Norcross look to remain unbeaten, taking on Parkview, while South Gwinnett went on the road to battle with top 10 ranked ML King. Plus, we get in the mind of our very own Will Hammack, and we unveil this week's building blocks. You're watching Gwinnett Prep Rally on GCPS TV. For 19 years, the county's high school sports television program.
For two decades, Calder Sports has been making dreams possible for thousands of Gwinnett County student-athletes.
Sometimes we've been over the top.
Thrill is gone.
Steve Calder sings.
And the leader of the clan will take no prisoners on this day.
Sometimes we've been straight to the point.
Beverly Coulter is the most persuasive sporting goods salesman in Gwinnett County history, and that's including her son, Steve.
But most of all, we've cared deeply about every Gwinnett parent and student who walked through this front door.
Over all these years,
we thank you for your support.